Namaste student, today we are going to start a new chapter, that is Euclid geometry. Here the geometry means part of mathematics. What is geometry? It's a part of mathematics that study the size, shape and dimension of the things. This geometry word come from Greek, that means geo plus metrein. Geo means earth and metrein means measurement. That means to measure the line. Who is the father of geometry? Euclid. He was a Greek mathematician. He has written a book, The Element. There are 13 volumes in it. And whatever we are going to study in class 9 and 10, geometry, that is Euclidean geometry. Indian mathematician contribute to geometry were Vaskara, Aryabhatta, Brahmagupta. Euclid geometry deal with flat surface only, and the surface which are not flat, that means three dimension, like this plane. Okay, this is your non-Euclidean geometry part. So there are three type of geometry. One is Euclidean geometry, one is spherical geometry, and another is hyperbolic geometry. We'll not discuss these two geometry. It is not there in our syllabus. We'll discuss only Euclidean geometry. This means geometry of plane figure is called Euclidean geometry. Plane figure means two dimension. Okay. So here there are three undefined terms in this two dimension. So you can see that one is point. No breadth, no length. Line, only the length. And plane have length and breadth. Okay, so in this chapter we'll see three terms. One is postulate, another is axioms, another you will see that is theorem. So what do you mean this postulate or axioms? Both have the same definition. That means a mathematical statement that is accepted as true without proof. That means there is no proof for them. Euclid said that this is the things and you have to go with that without any proof. Okay. So there is little difference between axioms and postulate. Axiom is wider term than vast term, broad term. Throughout the mathematics, we are using axioms. And the axioms which are using in geometry, especially that axioms have a special name called postulate. There are five postulates in our syllabus. We'll discuss that all. Now our first target is to complete axioms. So we'll see these all axioms. You can see here there are seven axioms. You can write these all by pushing the video. Okay, now no need to write, just you try to understand. I will explain these all seven axioms one by one. Okay, so let's see what are the meaning of these all. So here we will go for first one. So first one says things which are equal to the same thing are equal to one another. What is the meaning of this? Now, if A is one thing which is equals to C, this is another thing, and B is another thing which is equal to the same thing. Look at here, A is equals to C and B is equals to C, then A must be equals to B. This is your first axioms. Things which are equal to the same things are equal to one another. This is your first one. Okay, now second one. If equal are added to equals, if equals are added to equals, like if A is already equal to B, then if we'll add equal thing on both sides, if we'll add equal thing on both side, then it will remain same. Whatever whole thing will get, that will remain same. The whole are equal, that means this is your whole, like 2 kg mango, 2 kg banana, and if we'll add 1 kg apple and 1 kg apple on both side, then remain silly at 3 kg and 3 kg. Okay, that is your second one. Next, if equal are subtracted from equal, the remainder are equal. That means the opposite of this one. If we'll have A equals to B, and then if we'll subtract equal thing from both side, that means if we'll take out C from both side, same amount of thing, if we'll take out from both side, then the remainder will remain same. They are saying this one. Okay, third one. Now fourth one, things which are coincide with one another are equal to one another. That means if we'll take a line L and another line if we'll take M, and if we'll keep one line on another, and you can see that both are coincide to each other, that means you cannot see the other line, then you can say that L equals to M. Like you will take these two page, okay, if we'll take these two page, you can see, if you'll see here, see I am coinciding with each other, you can see that. So then they are equal to one another. This is one page and this is another page. I will coincide, look at here, from each part they are equal. Here you can see that, you cannot see the other one. So that means they are coinciding to each other, that means they are equal to one another. Okay, the meaning of that one is this. Next one, the whole is greater than its part. That means if we'll take one cake and if we'll break it in four equal parts, okay, or any part, if we'll take, no need to take equal part, whatever part you want to take, take it. Now you are taking this part, okay. Now remember, the whole, this is whole, again from beginning, if you'll think from the beginning, whatever it is, the whole thing is always greater than its part. Remember, the whole thing is always greater than its part. That this one is saying that. Next one is what? Things which are double of the same thing are equal to one another. The very simple thing are equals one. If two things are there, like A equals to B, and if we'll double it, double means multiply 2, that means it will remain same. This is not only limited to double. If we'll triple it, multiply 4 times, 5 times from both sides, in the both sides, we'll get remain same thing. Okay, next one, things which are half of the same thing. That means if you have A equals to B and divide it, take the half part of it, that means whatever remain, they will remain same. That is the thing. There are seven, okay, seven postulate, and these are seven pillar, you can say that, in algebra you can say, and we are using these all, and we are proving the rest of whatever we have discussed in junior class and whatever we're going to discuss in the higher classes, that means in class 9 and 10, and in higher classes we're going to see your non-Euclidean geometry also. Okay, in the next chapter we're going to, not next chapter, next class we're going to discuss about the postulate. There are 5 postulate, we'll discuss this one. Okay, thank you.